There's you are.
Oh, see you again.
1 minute.
That one church and
you're as good as Margaret. Oops, sorry.
Yeah, it's on now.
It's on now. Yep. Okay. So
I'll go 30 seconds. Five, four, three, two, one.
Good morning. My name is Reverend Philip DeLong. On behalf of the pastors and our Board of Trustees, we welcome you to Colby Memorial Temple for our Sunday service. To begin our service, Linda Angio will light three lights symbolizing the unity of body, mind, and spirit. Please stand for our invocation and stand and remain standing for our first hymn. Infinite Intelligence, Divine Creator, Father, Mother, God, we thank you for this gathering today. We thank you for being in the light, and through this light, may it give us peace and harmony. And so it is. Amen. Our first hymn will be led by our vocalist, Jamie Osman.
If you can turn to the back of your book for How Great Thou Art. Oh, I gotta push the button.
Oh Lord, my God, when I wonder, conceive all worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the thunder, thy power. The universe display. Then sings my soul, sing your God to me. How great thou art. Then sings my soul, sing your God to me. When through and forest lands of wonder, timber sings sweetly in the trees. When I'm down from lofty mountain grandeur and see the broad and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, Savior, to thee. How hard, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, Savior, to thee.
Thank you. You may be seated.
Located on the handout are our Declaration of Principles. Please join with me in reciting these principles together. We believe in infinite intelligence. We believe that the phenomena of nature, both physical and spiritual, are the expression of infinite intelligence. We affirm that a correct understanding of such expression and living in accordance therewith constitute true religion. We affirm that the existence and personal identity of the individual continue after the change called death. We affirm that communication with the so-called dead is a fact scientifically proven by the phenomena of spiritualism. We believe that the highest morality is contained in the golden rule. Whatsoever ye would that others should do unto you, do ye also unto them. We affirm the moral responsibility of the individual, and that he makes his own happiness or unhappiness as he obeys or disobeys nature's physical and spiritual laws. We affirm that the doorway to reformation is never closed against any human soul here or hereafter. We affirm that the precepts of prophecy and healing contained in the Bible are divine attributes proven through mediumship. Now, this is a special day in Casadega, and we have a renewal of vow ceremony. So,
I would like to the couples who are renewing their vows to please rise and come forward. Diane and Donald, Robin and Mark. Milagros and Victor. Joe and Linda. And anyone else that would like to come forward. We are gathered here today in the presence of infinite intelligence for the purpose of renewing your wedding vows.
Love is the greatest gift God has given humankind. It is a gift composed of the noblest virtues, kindness, patience, the ability to forgive, loyalty, and self-sacrifice. Love is a never-ending experience that enriches and fulfills our lives. Marriage, the union of two people in heart, body, mind, and spirit, is the greatest expression of love. It is the promise of two people to care for one another, to face all of life and its problems together, and to share their joys, feelings, thoughts, hopes, and dreams. Marriage is a promise to keep sacred the trust that is already shared, to nurture the faith that two people have in each other. This is one of the highest, happiest, and best moments of your lives. You are about to discover a greater love for each other, in renewed faith in each other for the future. Let us remember the words of Paul when he wrote in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4-8. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Just as the delicate bud of a rose does not reveal the true beauty of its full blossom, neither does the first flush of romance reveal the true beauty and totality of love. For this reason, we are gathered today to rededicate your marriages. Please turn towards each other and hold both hands.
Do you rededicate yourselves to your union of marriage, pledging to be kind, faithful, forgiving, and open-minded? Repeat after me. I come to you in faith, honesty and love, desiring to share with you my hopes and dreams, my thoughts and feelings, my life. I want to be your companion and share your life with you in a way no other person ever has before. I happily entrust my heart to your loving care.
Continue to hold your hands and touch each other's rings. May these rings, which are exchanged in virtuous and righteous faith and with hearts brimming in love, continue to bring blessings to the wearers of eternal love and devotion to each other. May the circle of these rings, representing unity, never be broken. We ask that they live together forever and always in perfect peace and become one in body, mind, and spirit. Having heard these vows you have made to each other, by the authority vested in me as a spiritualist minister, I now pronounce you a renewed couple. United life partners, and you may now seal your vows with a kiss. Okay, always remember, two hearts are better than one, and love conquers all. So if we could have another round of applause. Love. Okay. And we do have certificates that Ann will give. Okay, maybe later. All right. We are now going into the healing portion of our service. The healing prayer is located in the back of your hymnal. Please recite with me the prayer for spiritual healing. I ask the great unseen healing force to remove all obstructions from my mind and body and to restore me to perfect health. I ask this in all sincerity and honesty, and I will do my part. I ask this great unseen healing force to help both present and absent ones who are in need of help and restore them to perfect health. I put my trust in the love and power of God. Now, for those of you who would wish to receive spiritual healing, please take a seat along the wall and go to the next available healer. While the healers work, the rest of us will join in a guided meditation. I would like you to relax comfortably in your seats. Place your feet flat on the ground, making a connection deep within Mother Earth. Place your hands in your laps, palms up or palms down. Close your eyes and listen to the sound of my voice. Visualize a golden light enfolding you. This is the light from Source, from Infinite Intelligence, the Creator, Father, Mother, God. And as this light enfolds you, feel the love and the power of the universe entering the top of your head, flowing within and without, traveling down your spine and connecting to the core of Mother Earth. As you take a breath, you pull up Mother Earth's energies, the vibrations of love and purpose, as these vibrations flow within and without. As the energies of heaven and earth merge together, they flow into your heart center, where love, peace, and harmony resides. In front of you, you see a golden path. And as you follow this path, you are met by your healing guide and walk through a field of wildflowers. You walk through a patch of wild red roses. As this red energy enfolds your bodies, cleansing and healing where you need this red energy. As you breathe in the essence of the red roses, breathe in love, and allow that love to flow throughout your bodies. And feel the vibration of that love, vitality, strength. You and your healing guide now walk farther along the path and walk through a patch of orange marigolds as this orange energy enfolds your bodies, cleansing and healing where you need this vibration. As you breathe in the essence of the marigolds, breathe in the vibrations of love, of peace again, of harmony. Breathe in the vibrations of spirit. Is my infinite source, and I trust that source. As you and your guide walk further along the golden path, you walk through a patch of sunflowers. As this yellow energy enfolds your bodies, cleansing and healing where you need this yellow vibration. As you breathe in the essence of the sunflowers, breathe in love, breathe in power, breathe in creativity, and feel the vibrations of will, thy will be done, flowing throughout your bodies. You and your healing guide now walk through a patch of rosemary as this green energy enfolds your bodies, cleansing and healing where you need this vibration. As you breathe in the essence of the rosemary, breathe in love, unconditional love. Breathe in forgiveness and breathe in gratitude for all of life. You and your guide now walk farther along this path through a patch of lavender as this blue energy enfolds your bodies, cleansing and healing where you need this vibration. As you breathe in the essence of the lavender, breathe in love, breathe in truth, breathe in courage, and breathe in the spoken truth. You and your healing guide now walk through a patch of African violets as this indigo energy enfolds your bodies, cleansing and healing where you need this vibration. As you breathe in the essence of the African violets, breathe in the vibrations of dreams, of visions, of manifestations. You and your healing guide now walk through a patch of gardenias as this white energy enfolds your bodies, cleansing and healing where you need this vibration. As you breathe in the essence of the gardenias, breathe in the vibrations of love, unconditional love, of hope, of faith. You are in perfect health. You are a perfect being, surrounded by the guide force healing energies. You and your healing guide continue to follow this path, and you reach a top of a hill where there is a bench. You sit on the bench and overlook the valley below. You see a magnificent mountain range in the background. In awe of infinite intelligence creation, in awe of all of nature, your healing guide stands behind you and places their hands upon your shoulders. And in the silence, receive healing from your guide. as you rise from this bench. You thank your healing guide for the healing energies that you received. Both you and your guide look over the valley again, at the mountain ranges in the distance. And from your heart center, send Mother Earth healing energies throughout the world, removing any discord, discomfort, or disease. And send these healing energies to all of the kingdoms, the mineral kingdom, the plant kingdom, the animal kingdom, to all of humanity. Or you see hungry people, see them fed. Or you see homeless people, see them with shelter. And send love, peace, healing, and harmony to all the leaders of the world, that decisions are made for the highest good and peace exists everywhere. You and your healing guide now return along the golden path. And you walk through the gardenias, the African violets, the patch of lavender, the patch of rosemary. The patch of the sunflowers, the marigolds, and the wild red roses. And here you thank your healing guide once again, as you walk this golden path back into your heart center. And in your heart center, feel that love, that peace, that harmony. Know that you can call upon these healing energies at any time, and that your guides will administer these healing energies as they see fit. For you are love. And you are loved. Become aware of your surroundings. Wiggle your fingers. Wiggle your toes. Imagine you are a majestic tree with roots going far down into Mother Earth. Take a deep breath from the soles of your feet to the top of your head, fully grounding yourselves. Place your hands in a prayerful position in front of your heart center, thanking Spirit for the healing you received and that you were used as a healing channel. When you are ready, open your eyes. If you have received a healing resulting in a correction or improvement, please complete the yellow card in the back of the temple on this side. It looks like this. And give it to the pastor at the back of the temple or mail the card to us. We would like to thank our healers for sharing their gifts of healing. And our healers today were Lori Carter, Marty Hathaway, Reverend Judy Cooper, Coquette Cruz, Reverend Sheldon Gamberg, Daryl Demerit, and Reverend Deborah Ganberg. And I thank you. Jamie will now lead our next hymn.
If you can stand and turn to page 70, Amazing Grace.
The sound that saved us so lost, but now I found, was blind but see, 'twas great. And grace, did that grace appear? The just and snares I have me safe thus far, and grace when we years, pride shall to see praise than wait.
Thank you. You may be seated.
Our guest speaker today is Colin Hall. He is from England and has been working as a medium and spirit artist for over 30 years. Aside from visiting us here in Florida, he has also worked in Switzerland, Austria, and Maine. He greatly enjoys presenting at church services, speaking about spiritual philosophy and evidential mediumship. Colin teaches workshops helping people to connect to spirit through art and to become more aware of their spiritual gifts. For those of you who are interested, there is more information on Colin's website, which is www.colinhallart.com. And it is a pleasure to introduce Colin.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here as well. It's a wonderful church you have here. And I feel it goes back with a lot of history as well, and must have been a lot of really interesting people stood. All right, sure. Thank you. Yeah. I do have a quiet voice, so if anyone, if the voice goes down, just put your right hand up, put your left one up, then you're going to the bathroom. Let's just talk about spiritualism, because it's a wonderful religion, you know. The more you get into it, there's no dogma, it's just a way of life. And I think spiritually, we are living in, spiritually helps us go living in a spiritual way in our lives, you know, because we have life at the moment. It's got more and more complicated at the moment around the world, and we are living in a world of change, you know, change with religions, change with say politics and the material world and the spiritual world, and there seems to be a political turmoil going in at the moment as well with people. A lot of people as well thinking about religion, or not, it's a lot of people not doing anything at all in religion. And it's a pity really, because we all have a soul, and this soul just needs as much feeding as a physical body. And if we can have this balance between with the material and the spiritual, it does help us go through life. We're not here a long time. We was here 100 years. It's still very short, because really we go into other dimensions from here. So we may as well do the best we can on this earth plane, because everything we do, you know, all the good and the bad we take with us. So we may as well try our best to send positive thoughts out. And this one thing about this church, and spiritually church, healing, asking for help, it's helped thousands and thousands of people over the years. A mediumship. I met this old lady, a medium, and she was telling me a story that when she was, I think her son, is about 20, was in the Air Force, and she had a dream. In the dream, she seen him fall down on the floor, and these two ambulance men came up with a stretcher, put him on the stretcher, and ran away with him to the body away, but took the stretcher away. But on the floor, the body was still there. And she said to her husband, "I think Jimmy's going to be killed, going to die. Anyway, he's coming on leave this weekend, so I'm not going to tell him this picture to see him." Anyway, he came on leave and he went back home, back to the barracks or the wherever he was. And must have been about a week or so later, he had an accident. And what happened? Apparently, he was doing something on the electrical circuit. It blew up. And even in the dream, it was all in black. And that's what happened to him when he got electrocuted. And she said, when she was a few days later, she was at home with her husband. And she said, "I can see him. His back is here now from the spirit. Get me a pencil. I want to write down what he's saying." And because she asked for the pencil, because she asked for the paper, the contact was lost, you see. But the picture, she remembered the picture, she could see all these buildings, the street and so on, so a few pictures or symbols in her mind. Anyway, in the funeral, when she had to go to the barracks when the funeral was on, everything he shown her was there. It was just exactly as she could see in the dream. And she realized then to herself that he was from coming back from the spirit world, but said from that experience, yet it was very traumatic for her losing her son. She said, "Are they able to help?" Because the mediumship was really, really, really medium. "Are they able to help thousands and thousands of ladies who've lost their babies or sons, you see?" Because she knows exactly what they're going through. You know, the feelings from losing a child, from losing the sons, the daughters, you see. So because of that, they said she was able to help. And it's just that feeling, knowing what they're going through in time, you see. Now, in spiritualism, you will have a lot of it. Once you get more involved, especially if you join a meditation class and got more involved, as I said, it is a wonderful religion. It gives us a chance, an opportunity to go in this balance within the soul, you see. You always have, you will have some wonderful experiences just for yourself. You could say, you know, spiritual experiences. As you know, I'm an artist. I always go for a walk every day. And near where I live, there's a very old graveyard. I like looking at some of the stones because of the carvings on the stones. It's because it's usually, I've noticed a lot of ivy on the stones carved and flowers and different ones. And it's very peaceful there. And as I was walking to this graveyard, it's on a bit of a slope and there's a church on the top. As I was walking up, above the trees, really above the trees, I said, oh, look, it's an angel. I've seen an angel. Very tall, it must have been like 20 feet above the trees. And well, it's like a bit of a shock in a way. Only shock, but a nice vision. And it's there. And I thought, the more I was walking up to where she was, where I could see her, I knew there was a funeral going on. I didn't see anybody. I couldn't see a soul because of the trees, but I knew there was a funeral. I knew it was a baby girl that had died as well. And I got to the top, went to the top, and there was a funeral, so I just carried on walking. And that picture was in my mind, and it was so powerful. I was thinking about the days later. So I had to go back, see if I could find out a little bit more. So a few days later, I went back, and where the funeral was, there was no grave yet. There's a lot of flowers on the floor. And I stood there, I remember, I was looking at the flowers, and that's why I've seen the angel. She's come, you know, come for the little girl. And the voice said, no, she's come for the mother. Well, that gave me another shock. Because I thought, I'd had the right answer. But really, when you think of it, it's completely wrong. The little girl's in heaven now. It's the mother now who's going through all these difficulties in life, especially she's losing a child as well. So I was asking more when I went away. Now, after the first vision lights, a few hours later, I thought, well, it wasn't an angel, really. She had no wings, and she reminded me of more like the Maria figure coming down, you see, Mother Mary. Anyway, a few days later, I needed to know more about it, see. So I went again, and I could see her stood there in front of me. So I connected into her consciousness, and what she showed me was like a doorway. I walked in, and as if I walked into her, and she stood. I was walking around a stairwell inside, and at the top, I came to the door, like a church door, walked through the door, and I was in a room, and I walked in the room. There's a window. I looked through the window, I seen the trees and the lake. Then I come out, I thought, what's that about? You know, and I came all the way down. Oh, what's so funny? What is this picture? What's it telling me? And I started walking then. I was walking through the graveyard. And on the right-hand side, I seen a big heart, a big black marble heart gravestone. I knew it because I walked into her heart. I had to look at it straight away. And I could see a little picture on it. And when I walked to the stone, there was a picture of a window. Inside the window was a lake and the trees, exactly what she showed me in herself. If to say, now do you believe me, you know? Now, since I've had hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of visions of her, and she's a healer for women and children. And she also she's a spiritual philosopher as well. And I'll tell you one more story about her, because over the years, it's come over and over again, but a lot of my spiritual philosophy is from him. And another time, I walked in this graveyard, seen a pair of golden hands. I never seen an old lady in the spirit world. And she wanted me to go in this direction in the graveyard. I couldn't see anything. I know it's over there, but I couldn't see anywhere to go. Anyway, I was just walking around in about maybe, then they got the name Elizabeth. And maybe 10 minutes later, I seen this old man. So I thought, it's over there, I've got to go to it. So as I was walking over to him, he was cleaning the gravestone. And I seen the name on the gravestone, it was Elizabeth. It was his wife. Well, I couldn't say, I didn't have the heart to say, have you seen your wife? So I carried on walking. Maybe 20 minutes later left, and I came back to the gravestone. And on it was a pair of golden hands. And the words were, and this is before computers, the words were, "Pray for us, Our Lady of Knock." I've never heard of Knock, but it sounds Irish to me. I'm sure it must be an Irish place. But those days, I can't just jump on a computer and put Knock here then. And it must have been about 6 years, 7 years later in Austria. And I was telling this lady the story, and she said, one of the relations is a priest, and he goes over to Knock in Ireland. And apparently in Knock in Ireland, maybe it's 18, 90 years ago, everybody in this village in Knock could see this this vision of this lady. And people, for days, this is the police, the vicars, everybody, even people was walking up to it, see if they could feel it. And what happened, in the end, they built a cathedral there, and it's called Our Lady of Knock. So it said, that's the lady I've seen. I could tell you more and more and more stories about it. I've even painted a postcard there as well. We see it all the time. It doesn't stay still. It's always growing. There's always some new information. That's spiritual. So we can never learn enough, because it's like a road that goes from here to the heavens. There's always something new to learn. Like my art, it's always something comes up different all the time. We never stop learning. And this is one thing about art, or the arts, it could be writing. You're on a pathway through life, and this pathway you're taking, we all have a soul. It's really the soul's journey. That's the main part about our lives. Material is important, but the main thing is about our soul and developing our soul. And one thing about the spiritualist church, it do help you to understand this and help you to get a little closer into the meditations to do with the healing, the contact with the spirit world, And it's all in your hands, There's no separation. The biggest problem we have as humans, we block ourselves. If we're not good enough, be either way and put obstacles in our way. We shouldn't be like that. We should be the other way. We should be letting the seeds within here come out and flourish and show themselves, you see. I feel we all have our spiritual gifts. Sometimes you feel like they're like seeds or like gold or diamonds with inside, just rough, and they need to come out and polish. And this is to do with our spiritual gifts, you see. And I said everyone in this room has a gift. Some people find it really in the end of their lives when they're retired and they find out they're very good at writing or very good at this, but and these gifts we have, they do connect with the soul, and the soul is to do with the inspiration. And this is what I talk a lot about, or try to not talk, more get involved in the workshops and working out inspiration. And that leads us, really, inspiration into a lot of different avenues, Maybe it's to do with healing. Maybe it's to do with writing or music. But this connection in here, this soul, it does help us to, once we get a contact with it, really start working on it, it does open our consciousness up to different realms. And these different realms, they are connected to the spirit world. People know about Tesla cars, don't we? Tesla, what a wonderful inventor he was. And he said, if you can try to put his quotes, look on the computer about his quotes, he must have been a very, very spiritual person. His quotes are, he's talking about other universes, other dimensions. He didn't call it the spirit world, maybe he did in some cases. He said, what he used to do is sit down and he was channeling this information through. I mean, well before his time, his experiments, his thoughts, his ideas, his his scientific mind. He was connected with a scientific mind above. And he said this is how a lot of his inventions, even now. I know the first thing they did when he died, the CIA locked all his material up. It's that advanced. He didn't want anyone else to get their hands on it as well. It's still locked up to this day, you see. So it tells one thing, that even, a scientist has a connection to the spirit world, or an artist, anybody, even someone doing healing as well. Even the farmer in the field asking for rain or for his crops, you see. So anyway, I think I've said enough now. I'm going home, so thanks for coming. Goodbye.
Thank you, Colin, for sharing your experiences and your thoughts on spiritualism. And it's always great to get the personal side through on the messages and the talk. So thank you again. During our musical interlude, we will be passing the offertory basket, and we thank you in advance for your generosity. And Jamie will sing our interlude.
Thank you. I always love an English cemetery. I was married to a Brit for 18 years, so I got the luxury of visiting many. But so today is a celebration of love with the renewal of vows. But whether you have a significant person or not, one thing I can guarantee is that we are all love, every single one of us. Okay. That's not it.
The rose and spot.
And we have fun. Turn it up just a little bit. Some say love, it is a river that drowns the tender breeze. Some say love, it is a razor that leads your soul to bleed. Some say love, it is a hunger, nay, saying me. I say love, it is a flower, and you, it's only seed. It's the heart afraid of breaking that never
learns to dance. It's the dream of railway that never takes the chance. It's the one who won't be taken. Can not seem to give, and the soul of living dying that never learns to live. When the night has been too lonely and the road has been too long, and you think that love is only for the weak and the strong, just remember far beneath the bitter snow lies the sea that with the sun's love in the spring becomes the road.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jim.
Infinite intelligence, we are so grateful for this kind generosity. We ask that these gifts be used for the highest and best for Cascadia spiritual wisdom. And so it is. Amen.
We have some announcements now. Our message bearer for our next demonstration of spirit service next Wednesday, February 15th, is Robin Marotino. Next Sunday, February 19th, our guest speaker is Darlene McCormick. Next Sunday, our Lyceum speaker is Pauline Gold. Every Sunday, we have Adult Lyceum, which is also referred to as Sunday School, from 9:30 a.m. to 10:15 in the Colby Temple here. The service will be moving to the Andrew Jackson Davis building as of March 5th. So remember, be here next week. To participate in absentee healing, please print the name and the first initial of the last name of a loved one, friend, or even a pet in our healing book at the left corner of the Colby Temple here. Flyers for the camp events are at the back of the temple. We have an activities calendar and church bulletin in your hymnal for you to take home or give to a friend. And this is what these look like in your hymnals. Events for today, February 12th. From 2 to 4 p.m. in the Andrew Jackson Davis building, medium and spirit art will be with our guest speaker, Colin Hall. The workshop can help build your confidence in your art and mediumship and designed to open your creativity using pastel pencils. Once again, it's 2 to 4 at the Andrew Jackson Davis Building. The cost is $35. Also today from 6 to 8 p.m., Becoming a Spiritualist will be conducted by Robin Matutino at the Andrew Jackson Davis Building. The cost is $10. And this class is designed to cover what does it mean to be a spiritualist. Our website, Casadega.org, also has the monthly information as well as other upcoming events. Jamie will now lead our next hymn.
If you could stand, please, and turn to page 78, Sweet Hour of Prayer.
Sweet Hour of Prayer. And wishes no peace. Don't escape. Sweet hour, sweet hour. Do of me such a desires for the taste and
Thank you. You may be seated.
Colin Hall will be our message bearer for the next portion of our service. And please welcome Colin Hall.
It's nice to be up here again. Anyway, I know as a medium, you always I enjoy it very much. But one thing, when you start to developing, you do get very more sensitive, you know, and things that kind of, you know, it's nice doing the mediumship, but then being more sensitive, you get hurt very easy. You see, so if anyone says no, I'm going home straight away. You know, putting this in front of that. And I'll have to. Can I come to the lady there? You, yes, no, the one in front, I was aware of a gentleman. He came at his prime. He was in a uniform, army uniform, you see, and he walked right into you and he just saluted as well. But I felt the way he was coming towards you. I felt that he's bringing you a lot of energy, new power at the moment. I felt a lot of support from the spirit world. seems to be, and I'm aware that as I'm talking to you, I'm aware of a lady coming, you feel very much with your mother around you at the moment. It seems to be as if a lot of thoughts at home, I'm thinking a very lot, I'm putting things down, I'm wondering where to put them next, you understand? And but they are looking at you from the spirit world, and you, I know you must talk to them all the time anyway. I mean, a little creaking doors and cupboards. And she's opening the cupboards in the kitchen. Now, you must have something belonging in the cupboards from your mother. You understand? Do you still have your baking, anything to do with baking utensils from your mother? Yeah. What she wants you to do is bake me a cake, she said. It's wonderful being up here. I mean, I don't like saying it, but I mean... surprised when you get these. Oh, do you have some medals at home? Does it belong to somebody? No. Are they not in the family anywhere? No? No? Okay, then I'll leave it at that. Okay, then. There's a pin and a medal on you anyway. Oh, yeah, the dog was. The dog in the spinning world. When you see animals, I do see a lot of animals. When I do see dogs, I feel they're there for protection. Now, you're not thinking of moving, are you? Have you been some? I feel even you saying that there's some thoughts eventually where I want that. You understand? It's not plans yet, but it's in the future. And what? Oh, there's a birthday coming up shortly in the family.
Yes.
Why I'm saying that, because when I said you will move shortly, your mother came and she had a candle, you see. Now I felt. Where she showed me this candle with you. There's a long light around you, you see, and also show you the way. But also felt I could put it on a cake, you know, maybe it's my cake. I don't need a candle anyway when you do my cake. But, do you ever feel people, well, you must have feel people touch you anyway. You understand? I mean, children here touching me, you understand? It's like there's a dog here as well brushing up against me. I was all right until I came to you, you know. If I see the, I'll have to see the psychiatrist on Monday. Oh, I need a holiday, you know that, don't you? You do as well, don't you? Yeah. Well, find us somewhere nice to go if you sort the tickets out and I'll come with you, you know. Somewhere tropical, nice for Colin. And I've got to say, you don't eat a lot of chocolate, do you? No. I feel like I've got to leave it alone, you know. So sugars especially, you understand. We all should be aware of this anyway. And you do a lot of thinking if you go to bed. I feel like I see you, and it's like as if I'm getting people touch you around the head. That's what it was. Month of May, you see your birthday, I need birthday in May. Because I forgot, when I was watching you from there, and I forgot to tell you, there's a lady stood behind you, but she's quite, I felt it was his mother when she was younger, you see. And what she was doing, she had flowers and she was putting flowers in your hair. And why she was doing that, and it reminded me of the May Day, you know, with the tradition of putting flowers in the month of May, you see. Are you changing it or having some decorations or something at home? I'm seeing with you, I want to see fish, I see, I always feel like, but like goldfish, but I always feel like feng shui. I'm not letting new energies in. I know you do healing, and that lady I was talking about, I'm seeing with you, this Maria figure, you see. And I know you must have a place at home where you meditate. There's crystals there and some religious artifacts, you understand? And there's a nice presence around there as well, you see. And anyway, you're not putting any wallpaper up, are you?
I'm trying to pull some down.
Oh, you're pulling it down. Well, leave it up to set, you know, too late now, anyway. No, they just brought me wallpaper. I'm seeing new patterns come down for you, see, you know. And I'm looking at this. It's a lot of colours, you see. I've got to give you a lot of colours from the spirit world for healing coming round as well. Okay, I'm going to leave you now. I'm still aware of your mother. She's pussing over you like she's, you know. Do you have some of her jewellery? Do you have some of her No, but do you have something that goes around the neck? Yeah, gold, is it? Well, she's very generous, your mother, isn't she? But she said, Colin, that would fit you. I'm really enjoying it. I'm going to come here again. So, what you could do when you bring the cake, bring that chair with you. All right, I'll have to leave. Okay. Comes that lady with her arm stretched up. Yeah, hi. Hi, okay. When I was sat down, I was watching you. Being an artist, a lot of my pictures come in symbols. And what happens when I work, I see symbols or people, and then it starts to build from there, you see. And two things I'd seen with you, it's only when you was in the meditation, you know. You do healing.
Yeah.
Because I seen the shaft of light come down on you, all the way down into your head. And I was aware of an angel at the top. And this is how I get my inspiration, the art, you see, you know. But you talk to the spirit worlds as well, and the angel world. Now, have you ever heard music when you're half asleep and half awake? Yeah, because I know the angels are playing musical instruments above, you see. Sometimes when I do a lot of this work, I ended up going into, like in meditation, it takes me into different realms. And sometimes I hear monks chanting, angels singing, musical instruments, but I hear it in the room. But if I, I'm aware of it, sometimes it goes because I've just come out. Anyway, I call it music from the heavens and the coming round, you see. Now, do you have a daughter?
No.
No. Do you have a sister then?
No.
Okay. Do you know where there's a child in the spirit world, in the family? Did your mother or grandmother lose a baby? A stillborn?
No,
it's okay. Leave it there. I've seen a good child with you, but it's somewhere anyway. Maybe it's to do with an auntie, uncle. When I see children, I know they bring up, you've been healing children. I said, well, in your hands, I've seen a rainbow.
Yes.
And underneath this rainbow is a child. And that's what I've seen there, you see. So watch for healing children. Maybe she could be mentally or something, but I feel someone's going to talk about the daughter, sister, and they need some help.
Yeah.
You understand that now?
Yeah, well, I understand, especially the rainbow just recently as well.
Yeah.
But also, when my mother was living,
yeah,
she did lose a son before she passed.
All right, okay. And it's all those rainbow ends, but I know it's going to for healing. And it was underneath the rainbow was a child. That's why I just keep talking about this children anyway. So be aware of that anyway, helping children. And at the moment, I've seen a lock with you, a padlock, and I'm trying to open it. I feel there's something in your life at the moment. I'm just frustrated about. I need to... I can't get out, do you understand?
Yes.
And you need a holiday as well, don't you?
Yes.
I'll tell you, sure, okay. They want you to take Colin as well, they said. Don't forget that as well. I need a holiday after this week. Well, me out of it. Anyway, this is birthday anniversary around Christmas. I don't know, December, yeah. Did you know somebody who dressed up as Father Christmas? Did you know someone who dressed up as Father Christmas? No. Well, that's why I had to say it's the anniversary is at Christmas because of Father Christmas with you, you know.
Yes, there's a birthday at Christmas.
Yeah, right, that's okay. If you're not sure, just say yes, Colin.
Oh, no. Spirit name written.
Right. Oh.
And then he'll do that.
Yeah. I normally go to the awkward ones first, and anyway, you're okay. No, I'm joking. But you don't understand it, but I don't know. It's just that I could see Father Christmas. But I'll have to move on. But you do send a lot of love out to people.
Yes.
You do. It's like it radiates out. And even when this ceremony was here, I felt it touched, didn't it? It's, you know, I felt your heart, you know, love as well. Anyway, okay.
One another time.
Oh.
Thank you,
Carl. Thank you, anyway.
Sorry about that. Okay.
Okay, be sure to go to Colin's workshop today. You'll learn a lot of info, so. And thank you, Colin, for those messages. Okay, we would like to remind everyone that we will have our afternoon message service starting at noon in the Colby Temple here. So a group of mediums and student mediums will be giving spirit greetings to as many individuals as they can reach during that hour. Everyone is welcome. We encourage you to visit our bookstore, which is open from 11:30 to 5 p.m. today. And it is open Monday through Saturdays from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Please rise for our closing hymn and remain standing for the benediction. Jamie will lead us with Let There Be Peace on Earth.
It is on page 203 of your hymnal. Eileen, I want an airline ticket too.
Let there be peace on earth with me. Let us walk with each other in love. Let's begin with me. Let's begin with love.
Please take an attitude of prayer. Infinite intelligence. We are so grateful for this gathering today. We are so grateful for our messages we heard from our speaker today, Colin Hall, and the messages that he gave. But we are so grateful for the spirit of love that abounds not only around us, but in our hearts. And we ask that we go in peace and love. And so it is. Amen.
Amen.
Okay.
Thank you.